You can't set permissions on an Access app directly. Instead, you set permissions on the SharePoint site where the app was created. So when you need to manage permissions for your app, your first step is to check the permissions on the site. If you're already looking at your app, click Back to Site. On the site, click Settings, Site Settings. You need to be a site owner in SharePoint to manage permissions, otherwise you won't see site settings. On the Site Settings page, under Users and Permissions, click Site Permissions. The options for managing permissions are at the top of the page. The yellow band below that tells you whether or not your site has unique permissions. This site inherits permissions from its parent site. You can manage the permissions at the parent site, or if you want to manage the permissions separately for this site, you click Stop Inheriting Permissions. Next, you have the option to set up new groups or use existing groups from the parent site. Groups make it easier to manage permissions because you can set the permissions for just a few groups of people rather than lots of individual users. I like the defaults, so I'll just click OK. This brings us back to the home page, but we're not yet finished. And we'll see why if we go back to the Site Permissions page. So here we go. Settings, Site Settings, Site Permissions. When you stop inheriting permissions, all the groups and users are copied down from the parent site. So we have more work to do to get permissions how we want them. I see a couple groups I don't want anymore, so I'll remove those. And then I'll need to add users to my new App Visitors group. To do that, I click the title of the group. To add new users, I click New, Add Users. Type the names of the users and click Share. People in this group will be able to read but not edit the data. People in the Members group can edit data, and I want to remove people from that group. To remove users, select the users and click Actions, Remove Users. So that's how you manage permissions when your site inherits permissions or when you already have a dedicated site for your app where you can manage permissions separately. If you need to create a dedicated site for your app, watch the next video, Create a Site with Unique Permissions. For more information about creating and customizing Access apps, see related videos and articles.